I'm Richard Marcus, and I'm the greatest casino cheat of all time. I cheated casinos all around the world for $25 million. I sell everything I have and bought a convertible Mustang, and I drive out to Las Vegas. I get a job dealing cards in a casino. A guy by the name of Joe Klassen walks into the casino. And he was no doubt one of the greatest cheaters of all time, and he became my mentor. I joined up with his team, and we spent the next two decades cheating casinos out of millions all over the world. We spent thousands of hours practicing the moves, checking the angles, making sure the bets were precisely placed. Everything was a perfectly timed operation that had to be executed perfectly by each member. There was a person who set the casino up. There was a mechanic, the person that actually manipulates chips. Then there's a claimer who claims the cheated bet. And then, last but not least, and probably most important, there's our own surveillance and security. Everything had to be precise, and we had to do a lot of training to make sure there were no screw-ups. One of our famous moves, or I should say infamous moves, was to pass post. The term pass post comes from horse racing. It means we would make a bet after the winning number already came in. What really made me infamous in the casino world, quite infamous, it was a move called the Savannah move. This was the best pure psychological move that not only I, but everybody else in the casino industry has ever seen. Total domination. I walk up to a casino with a $5,000 chip and a $5 chip. I would bet it like this, purposely slanting the top chip off the bottom chip just enough so that the dealer in the position here from that angle looking at this bet would know there's two chips there, but in fact would only see the color of the top red chip and therefore assume that the bottom chip was of the same color. Now, the ball is spinning and I'm waiting here. Now, in my hand, I have two red chips. So if it's a losing number, smoothly, I don't have to do it fast. I just go out, pick it up. Okay, what did I put back? I put back two red chips. What did the dealer think was there? Two red chips. But on the other hand, had that bet won, and I just go, yes, I hit. There it is, 5,000 in the first column. Yes, sir. So the dealer would pick it up and boom, wow, $5,000 chip, that's a $10,000 payout. Never before done in a casino where the cheat move occurs on the loss, not on the win. Our moves were so powerful, they worked against all dealers all over the world. But in Monte Carlo, it got downright scary. This was gonna be the night to remember for all the wrong reasons. So I walk into the casino. You had to show ID to get in. And I hand my passport to the girl at the reception desk. And I'm watching her eyes as she's typing in the details of my passport, and I see a flood of, it's him, coming out of her eyes. And she said, just a minute, please. So about 3 minutes later, a big gentleman comes up to me and he says, Monsieur Marcus, do you speak French? And of course I said, no. The security guard told me to follow him into the back room. And at that moment, I thought to myself, this is really getting serious. And he takes me to this room, and in the room, there's already another guy laying photos of me across his desk of cheats I had done in Monaco the previous year. And it's like, wow, I guess they got me. He says to me, he's like, you know, struggling with his English, but he got a dictionary and he said cheat. I said, what? You think I'm a cheat? He's trying to say like, you know, don't play wise guy with us. We know who you are. He goes, look at the photos I have here. So now the fun starts. because they were both individually trying to grill me in broken English and trying to get me to say, yeah, I cheated. So now they start to talk strategy right in front of me. What they didn't realize is that I am French and I speak French fluently. So then, you know, they're telling me, just tell us what happened.
Monsieur, now is the time to tell us what happened here.
Amongst themselves, they're saying, all we gotta do is get them to say one thing and then we can put the handcuffs on them. You know, and then they're telling me, you know, just tell us what it is. You don't even have to get specific. Just tell us what happened, you know, what did you do?
Tell us what happened.
Nothing at all.
And it went on and on and on. And finally, you know, they see they're not getting anywhere with me. A half hour later, right? A guy shows up, and what I could see right away that he was not just the police. He was very high in the police, and he was pissed off. And now I'm thinking, whoa, I could really be in some trouble now. The security guard, he said, look, he's not admitting to anything, right? But, you know, we know that he's scared. The police guy looked at me, and he looked at him, and he shook his head. He don't look too scared to me, right? And I'm listening to all this. They're talking in French, right? And, you know, I'm sitting there like I don't understand anything. It went back and forth, and after 40 minutes, he goes, look, you got to just cut him loose. The two casino guys reluctantly agreed that that was going to be the end of it. The police guy, he says, all right, come with me. He says, yeah, don't come back here or else you might have some serious problems, all right? They don't have any evidence against you now, but that could change if you come back here. So I then said to him in French, in street French, I said, you think I'm really worried about what those two assholes are going to tell you about me? And he looked at me and he goes, tu parles français, là? Je dis, oui, je parle français. Bien sûr que je parle français parce que je suis français. What? You're French? You're not French. Goes, yeah, I'm French, all right. And he goes, you gotta be kidding me. And he's like, wow. And he goes, you know what? You're right. Those guys are assholes. And we start talking. Then he says to me, is it really true what they say about you? I say, can I trust you? Can I tell you that? He goes, come on. You think I'm gonna tell them? You think I care about them? Then he goes, show me. I go, what? Hey, you're the biggest cheat in the world. Let's see it. Just go in there, and I want to see what you do. Let me get this straight. Okay, you're the, what are you, the second command here or third in command? You go, I'm second in command here. You want me to go in and cheat a casino in front of you? And I'm going, you know, what the fuck? You only live once, right? You know, you got. I've always liked to play with fire, so to speak. Finally, I said, let's go. So I right in front of him, he was a little bit over my shoulder, standing behind me, and I did it. I pass-posted it. And then I turn around to see his reaction. And he's gone. Holy shit, is this a setup? I'm gonna get arrested. When I walk outside, at first I didn't see him, but then I see him, he's over like to the side. He's laughing. He's just laughing, right? Because he saw it. He saw the whole thing, and he understood it, right? And he goes, do you have the chips left? Did you cash them out yet? I go, no. He goes, give me the chips. I go, what? He goes, give me the chips. I go, wait a minute. No. I think I know what you're thinking. You're going to do this? Soon as he got the chips in his hand, he took them, and he went right back in that casino, and I yelled to him in French, just cash them out. I'm still left this day wondering, did the guy actually do it? My new friend, the senior constable of Monaco, with chips in his hand, possibly ready to do one of my cheat moves. What could have I been responsible for? A very high-ranking official of the Monte Carlo Police Department doing my cheating move. This, you can't make this stuff up. It's too good.